Hi everyone, Anthony Escrivens here. Welcome back to the channel. Today, I will share with you something very special. A few weeks ago, I passed my private pilot checkride, so I will share with you what I did to prepare for the checkride and also give you some tips on the day of the checkride and the day before the checkride, what you should do in order to feel rested and be comfortable and confident that you're going into this prepared and ready to take charge of that flight. I will share with you five tips that helped me prepare for the private pilot checkride. And the very first thing you should do is study the ACS. Download it, go to the FAA.gov site and download the ACS and go through it, because the examiner will go through the ACS line by line by line. They have to, it's their job. And a good examiner will tell you in advance, go through the ACS, that's exactly what I will use to test you and make sure that you know what every line means and what's expected of you on the day of the checkride. So very important. I know you spend a lot of time flying, a lot of time in ground school. Study the ACS, it will pay dividends. Okay, on to tip number two, practice your emergency procedures. Many of us are flying and our instructors will kill our engine and we go into land. Make sure that you rehearse your emergency procedures from the right to left, and you know, whatever you're working with your CFI, make sure that you have that rehearsed. You don't need an airplane in order to practice your emergency procedures. I literally took a picture of the cockpit and I did a lot of chair flying and I started going right to left, you know, carpet, mixture, throttle, etc., 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 and then just go through it. And before you know it, it's gonna be engraved in your brain, all that entire flow for your emergency procedure. So practice your emergency procedures. Of course, your soft and short field takeoff landings and all that stuff as well. Make sure that you rehearse them. But emergency procedures is a pretty critical skill that you'll not only need during the checkride, but in case of a real emergency as well. Tip number three, know your numbers. Know your V speeds, especially VA, maneuvering speed. What is maneuvering speed? Why is it important? So not just know the definition of it, but actually calculate your VA speed based on the current weight or the anticipated weight of the aircraft on the day of your checkride. Make sure you understand the formula and know how to calculate VA. It's very, very important. Your examiner will ask you about stall speeds. They will ask you about VX, VY, VA, very important. So just know your numbers, know the limitations of your aircraft, because how can you perform steep turns and slow flight and all of the other maneuvers if you don't know what limitations of your, if you don't know the limitations of your aircraft. So make sure that you know what they are. Open the POH and study your numbers. Write it down, memorize them. They will ask you about it. Tip number four, come prepared. Now, I spent about 2 days preparing for my checkride. Once I was comfortable that, you know what, this is the day and the weather looks good, everything is working in my favor for the checkride, I got a binder together and I put together all of my IACRA paperwork and my knowledge test, my nav log, going to the airport, coming back, the runway where I'll be landing, the anticipated entry into the runway, into the airport. My weight and balance is here. The envelope for the weight and balance based on the POH is here. My anticipated wind based on my flight level is also here. This is a printout from aviationweather.gov. And also, I brought this wind card, winds aloft card. This will basically something that you calculate on the ground before your checkride, and it will give you your anticipated ground speed based on your heading at cruise altitude. So extremely helpful if you need to work on diversions during your flight, which you will most likely get. And you can just pull out the wind card in case your examiner asks, okay, Mr. Pilot in Command, if you're flying a heading of 90 and now you need to fly a heading of 270, what is your ground speed and how long will it take us to get to that destination? So this wind card will give you your ground speed, and this is something that you can create and bring with you. It's gonna help you a lot on the day of your checkride. So prepare that wind card. So that's pretty much it. Just come prepared. Oh, another tip, don't bring an iPad. I've gotten mixed reviews on iPads. And so my personal feel on that is learn to fly with your sectional charts, with your E6B, old school, right? And navigate to your checkpoint the old school way and show the examiner that you know exactly what you're doing in that cockpit and you don't have to rely on an electronic. It's gonna make them feel 100 times more comfortable that you are the pilot in command flying the old school way. My fifth and final tip is be in charge of the flight, be that pilot in command, and have fun with the flight. Just show the examiner that you are prepared, that you mean business, and that nothing is gonna distract you, and you're in charge. Basically, you are the pilot in command. So be confident, have fun with the flight. You've done it before, you know what to do, just go out there and execute. So that's it, guys. I mean, this is very simple. You've trained for this for many, many months. You've studied, you know exactly what you need to do. Like I said, have fun, execute. And just to give you a bit of an insight on how my checkride went, we had about 2 hours of oral on the ground. Then we took off to my airport destination. And during the first checkpoint, he basically pulled my engine and I had my first emergency. I navigated all the way down to Sky Manor Airport. I was at about 3,000 feet and made a successful landing with an idle engine. After that, things went really, really smooth because I showed him that I could fly the airplane, I'm safe, I know my winds, I know the performance of my aircraft, my glide speed, and everything went as planned. Then we took off, we did more maneuvers, steep turns, slow flight, you know, all that good jazz, turns around the point, S turns. Then we went back to my home airport, which is Somerset, did a short field landing, soft field landing. He actually pulled my engine a second time for a second emergency procedure. And after that, we did about an hour and a half of flight. He basically turned to me and said, congratulations, you're a pilot. So that felt amazing. And that's pretty much it. Like I said, I had fun with it. I was very well prepared. I had done my homework and that's really all it took. So for me, it was just kind of a normal day. I went in with this attitude of, I'm gonna show off everything that I've learned over the last year of training. So, and that's exactly how I treated this checkride, and I had a lot of fun with it. So that's pretty much it. So hope this helped. Congratulations if you're approaching that checkride phase. And write in the comments, let me know what how your checkride went, or what are the things that you're most nervous about? See if myself or other viewers can help you. All right, safe flying. Ciao.